five facts that make The Dead Don't Die interesting. When talking about horror movies that capture the fancy of moviegoers, the subgenre of zombie flicks is a favorite pick. So for this year, the first zombie movie to elicit screams will be The Dead Don't Die, starting on June 14th. Get to know interesting facts about the zombie caper of the summer. Number 5. It's a horror comedy zombie movie. People got a first taste of The Dead Don't Die in March 2018 when one of its lead stars, veteran actor Bill Murray, spoke about the project. It's a zombie movie. Jim Jarmusch has written a zombie script that's so hilarious. It's titled The Dead Don't Die, and it shoots over the summer. But no, I will not play a zombie, Murray stated.
Jesus.
Actress Chloe Sevigny, another cast member, shared that The Dead Don't Die is more in the vein of a comedy. So don't be deceived by the somber-sounding, creepy title of a movie that seems to tell us it's just a matter of time before a zombie apocalypse explodes. Think World War Z or Train to Busan, which are the type of zombie movies that have saturated the market.
So what are you thinking?
What was it, wild animals?
But leave it to an innovative director like Jim Jarmusch to revitalize the genre. He's made comedies before, mostly utilizing deadpan humor, but based on the trailer, The Dead Don't Die might become the offbeat director's silliest and most popular movie yet. Number 4. It's directed by an indie maverick. For fans of mainstream tentpole Hollywood movies, American director Jim Jarmusch may not be on the radar, as he has not done blockbuster superhero flicks or sappy youth-oriented escapist movies. But in the world of indie filmmaking, Jarmusch is a legend. After all, he has been a proponent of independent cinema since the 1980s, with acclaimed films such as Stranger Than Paradise, Down by Law, Mystery Train, Dead Man, and Ghost Dog, The Way of the Samurai. He has been characterized as a minimalist filmmaker whose quirky films are unhurried. So it would be refreshing for the audience to find out what Jarmusch has to offer in a genre he isn't noted for. Although he has directed the vampire movie, Only Lovers Left Alive, starring Tilda Swinton and Tom Hiddleston in 2013, being attached as writer and director of a zombie comedy flick seems an intriguing prospect for Jarmusch. But the guy has always made fascinating movies, and hopefully The Dead Don't Die won't be different. Number 3. Musicians star in a zombie movie. Fans of singer-actress Selena Gomez will be happy to see her return to the big screen in this horror comedy after her appearance in 2016's The Fundamentals of Caring. In The Dead Don't Die, Gomez tries out the horror comedy genre, so this sounds interesting to her legion of fans.
Is it nice?
Gomez isn't the only musician showcasing her acting chops in the movie. Robert Fitzgerald Diggs, famously known as RZA the Rapper, is also part of the cast in an undisclosed role. Acting in films isn't new to RZA, as he was part of a number of movies, and most recent which was Brick Mansions in 2014. What's more interesting is the inclusion in this zombie-centered movie of two veteran musicians, Tom Waits and Iggy Pop. Named as one of Rolling Stone's 100 Greatest Singers in 2010, Waits has also managed to act in films since 1978 until now. Meanwhile, the enduring six-decade career of Pop, designated as the godfather of punk, includes appearing in a number of movies and TV series as well. But who between them will bring the scare as a flesh-eating corpse? Number 2. The story focuses on cops versus the undead. The Dead Don't Die follows a zombie epidemic in the fictional small town of Centerville, where the dead rise from their graves and force the townsfolk to fight for survival. Springing into action to combat the corpses feasting on the town's citizens are the three bespectacled local police officers. They also try to figure out how the zombie outbreak happened. Meanwhile, an expert mortician who has a penchant for samurai swords fights back at the newly risen dead in her own way. A group of millennials trapped in a hotel must also deal with the creepy new reality of zombie attacks. The movie will make its world premiere as the opening salvo in the 72nd Cannes Film Festival on May 14th to 25th in France, where it will be screened in competition with other films lined up for the annual cinematic event. Wow, if the movie made it in the Cannes selection, then it must be worth watching. Number 1. It is one of the best ensemble casts in 2019. The greatest zombie cast ever disassembled is the blurb on the movie's poster, and indeed, the star-studded ensemble cast is sure to attract audiences. Heading the cast is 2016 Mark Twain Prize for American Humor recipient Bill Murray as a police chief, forming a triumvirate with police officers Adam Driver and Chloe Sevigny in frontlining the battle against the zombies. Oscar winner Tilda Swinton plays a Scottish morgue worker who joins forces with the police, while erstwhile Disney Channel pop princess Selena Gomez leads the younger set of actors. Rounding up the cast are Danny Glover, Steve Buscemi, Rosie Perez, Austin Butler, Carol Kane, Caleb Landry-Jones, RZA, Tom Waits, and Iggy Pop. Guess who among them will be causing moviegoers to freak out as living corpses? Most of the cast members have collaborated with director Jim Jarmusch in the past, notably Driver in Patterson, Swinton in Only Lovers Left Alive, and Murray in Broken Flowers. So it's exciting to see how they will fare this time in Jarmusch's horror comedy with the rest of the talented cast. If you find this video infotaining, please subscribe to our channel and make us part of your daily habit.